Hi, I'm Rick Shaefer, and I'm doing a short video for the Nest open house, and which will be virtual this year, so we're doing videos. Just going to walk through a couple pieces that I've been working on that are in the studio right now, that are on the wall here. This is a piece, briefly, that I've had in the back of my head for a long time to do. Who knows where art ideas come from. This is kind of wrestling with the angel in the woods theme, but it also translates to a political aspect. It's got all kinds of things going on. Mainly it was an excuse to do this kind of fun landscape with these two guys wrestling on a stream. So anyway, it's been a really fun piece to do. So actually I'm going to walk you over to a larger piece that's on the wall. So this is a piece that's going out to be in a show at Silvermine, which will still be up when this video, when the art trail goes on. I think that this show is going to run through January 16th. It's the show concerns artists' responses to the idea of migration, immigration, population movements across the globe, the whole idea of flux, people in flux, and what's going to respond in response to conflicts, in response to economic deprivation or global warming, environmental issues, which are going to get only become worse and worse as we get into this heating up of the planet. And certain areas are not able to sustain human life. There's going to be movements of population. So this show called The Golden Door, which is lifted from Emma Lazarus's sonnet that's on the Statue of Liberty, about the inclusion, the way America's all about inclusion. Bring me your tired, basically bring me your refugees. And so this piece, which I did before the show was conceived, is titled The New Colossus, which is also the title of her sonnet. And it deals with, you can see, this huge structure being constructed out in this case, supposedly in the U.S. Southwest along the border. So it's a border wall. It's not, of course, it's my overhyped vision of an apocalyptic border wall, but it's kind of getting that across. The idea of demarcation, the idea of exclusion, the idea of keeping out, keeping in. Walls have always been through history, both for keeping in, keeping out. You know, we have prison walls, we have border walls, we have neighborhood walls, we have everything. The symbolism of a wall or a dike or a dam, because a lot of the imagery and a lot of the language around migration has water analogies, water symbolism in it. Ai Weiwei recently coined the term human flow to describe this migration, this flux of humanity. And it's so this, in my incarnation of this, there's this. Let me first of all explain to you, this is the back of the piece. I drew on the front and I'm painting the back, so it's going to be a layered kind of look. It's going to add more depth to the piece, hopefully. So this is the back. It's a bit difficult to photograph because it's kind of got a glossy sheen. But this will all get painted in various tones of gray to augment the drawing that's on the other side. So real briefly, because I don't take up a bunch of time. This is a committee of people, some familiar people. I won't even get into who they are. Looking at the plans for this, angels in the sky, the heavens are involved. This is also relates to all those 17th and 16th century lithographs and celebratory prints that were made for big battles or for big projects like the building of Versailles or something like that. So there's a huge tradition of these massive monumental, not this big, but lithographs or engravings to memorialize those events. And I've copied the kind of verbiage that would be down at the bottom of the crest, often the crest of the king or the pope or whoever was sponsoring the propaganda at the time, I guess. So this copy, which is now backwards, relates to this piece, describes the building of this wall and the questions around it, why, and the planners and the people who were involved in the building of it say, oh no, this is going to be some monument to man's greatness. So a bit of Ozymandias, the poem of Ozymandias in it too, where the arrogance of leaders is shown by a crumbling statue out in the desert. Anyway, this has got a whole ton of references, which I hope when people get to see it in person can start to parse. I'm going to do a little bit of, I'm going to do an interview for the show, so there'll be a bit of explanation. I'm probably going to do some literature, so there'll be some explanation about what's gone into this and what these various elements attempt to convey. There's discordance of time, where you've got really old lifting devices and 50s trucks and modern helicopters and angels and this vernacular of the curtains, which were often part of this back to the 17th, 18th century lithographs and engravings to show the majesty of the event. So there's all those pieces in here, and I especially drew from, I think, Peter Bruegel the Elder's paintings. He did a couple of them in the Tower of Babel, where he shows this man just building this massive thing, the tower at that point, the Tower of Babel, but with these various mechanical devices which they were using back then, and building it out of the bedrock, which I've sort of included in this. So there's a little indications of that Tower of Babel foolishness incorporated in this piece. So anyway, I hope if you can get to the show, it's in New Canaan, Connecticut. It's, as I said, it's running through to January 16th. And my piece will be in it. It's a group show. It should be a really good group show because there's a lot of, they've been able to get a lot of good, really good artists from all over. So I think it's going to be worth seeing. And that would be great. Anyway, that's my little contribution to this video story. And thanks for paying attention.